We're back with another DIY video. Let's do this.
Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul and seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons.
What is up, you guys? It is Megan. Welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new, make sure you just hit the like button, hit that subscribe button, comment on future videos. Hit the bell next to the subscribe button so you guys can get notified whenever I upload a video, which is going to be every day in the month of October, which is almost over because it is the 31 days of Halloween on my channel. I am Megan Elizabeth, and let's get on to this DIY video. So instead of just focusing on one DIY project today, I wanted to give you guys a video with some different ideas that you guys could do to kind of make some fall and Halloween inspired DIY crafts. So I have my handy dandy Michaels bag in here, and I'm also going to be using the items that I'm making today in another video, so you guys will get to see them in two different videos. I have so many things that I purchased at Michael's, so I'm just going to kind of be going through one by one. But so the first thing I got was I got four of these mugs. They were $3.99 at Michael's, and they come with a little set. So I'm going to be showing you guys how to make different kind of Halloween and fall inspired mug designs. In addition to that, I have three mason jars that I'm going to be doing some paint on the inside of some kind of cool little festive Halloween mason jar ideas. And finally, I have picture frames. So I'm going to be showing you guys how you guys can kind of spice up these little picture frames and give them to your... So in addition to all of that, I have a pack of paintbrush, and I also have some red, black, and yellow paint that I'm going to be using. So you guys are going to be seeing me doing this kind of from different angles and different... It won't necessarily be just standing right here, but the main video is going to be here. So let's do it. So the first craft that I'm going to be doing is going to be probably the most time-consuming one. So you're going to need to get all of your mason jars. So I'm going to be doing it one by one and doing a time lapse of me doing it. You're going to need a paper plate or a bowl or something to put the paint on, your paint, and your paint brushes. So basically, I'm going to be starting off with a pumpkin design. So I'm going to need some orange paint and a paintbrush. We're going to just pour some paint on here. Like that. So I'm just going to start with that much because I'm not going to do that heavy of a coat on the inside. And then I'm going to get one of my paint brushes. So I'm probably going to use, of this kit, I'm probably going to use this kind of thickness of a brush. So you guys can either paint on the inside or the outside. I'm going to be doing the inside because I feel like that's going to be an easier cleanup kind of process. So all I'm going to do is I'm just going to take some paint and I'm going to paint the inside, just so I'm not going to do that thick of a coat, but I'm just going to kind of paint the inside so all of the inside is orange. Obviously it's not going to be perfect, but kind of just a design. So I'm going to do a time lapse of me doing that. So this is what mine looks like now that it's done. Obviously, it's not going to be perfect. And it would probably be better if you had a mason jar that just went up and not the little handles. So I'm gonna wait for this to dry a little bit more before I paint the eyes of the pumpkin. But basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be doing a ghost. And then I'm going to be doing two pumpkins and a ghost. If you had purple paint, if you had green paint, you could do Frankenstein. I actually might take the paint from here and do Frankenstein. But basically you guys can kind of get creative with whatever ones that you want to do. But I will be doing a ghost, and I think either pumpkin or Frankenstein. So I'm just going to do a time lapse of me doing that. So let's do it. So as you guys can tell, this is what the pumpkin one looks like when it's dried. This is my ghost, and this is half of my Frankenstein. So basically what I'm going to do is, because I am probably still going to use the other ones, is I'm going to take a smaller brush to do detail work. And we'll start with the ghost. And basically what you're gonna do is you're just gonna like, I'm gonna pick the front. I'm just going to attempt to draw eyes on the inside and hopefully it'll come through. If not, I also have a black Sharpie that we're going to be using for other ones. And we might just draw it on the outside. And what you would do to make sure that if you wanted to use this for food, I will be using these for decoration purposes. You would bake it in the oven at 350 degrees. I think it's for like 10 minutes. And that would make sure all the paint is like stuck on the thing, but I would recommend only using these for decoration. So I'm gonna do that right now. Just draw some ghost eyes. Oh, you can totally see that. Okay, that's good. Can you get a little ghost eyes? So there's one of my eyes, and then I'm going to come over here. I'm gonna get some more paint. And then I do the second eye. And then for his mouth, I'm gonna come here and we're gonna do that. I am probably gonna do a few coats of this so it stands through more on the white, but you're gonna want to wait for it to dry first. So yeah, your ghost is going to look something like that. So obviously you would do the circles better, but I'm gonna go through a couple more times and do it. Obviously I am no artist or drawer or anything, but I think that this looks pretty cute. And obviously you can do darker layers or more layers. So this is my ghost. So basically I'm just gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna make a pumpkin design on the front, and then I'm going to finish off Frankenstein's top part, and then your mason jars are going to be done and we will move on into our next one. When you are done, your mugs or mason jars are going to look a little like these. Do those are kind of drying. I might come back and touch them up and do a little bit more on Frankenstein. I'm gonna move on to my mugs. That's actually a lie. We're going to do the picture frames because they require paint or markers as well. So I just went to Michael's and I just got the mini ones. Obviously you guys could do bigger ones, you guys could do even smaller ones, but just because these are gonna be the easiest and were the cheapest, and I wanted to give my friends kind of little small frames. I'm going to use some of the paint, and also I got Sharpies because I will be doing the mugs next, and I'm gonna use Sharpies instead of paint for them, so I will be just using both. So basically you can do kind of whatever designs you want. I'm gonna do some pumpkins, maybe some ghosts, kind of just some fun funky little designs. You basically can do whatever you want. This is just an idea of what if you want inspiration to do frames. If you even wanted to do a bigger frame, you could do something like that. You could do Halloween Disney inspired. It kind of just depends on your art talent. You know, it just is whatever you're struggling to use open. It is basically whatever you want. So yeah, they're just tiny little frames. So for this one, I'm going to start off with, I should have got green. What do I want to do? I need an inspiration first. I'm going to paint the whole frame black, and then I'm going to draw little pumpkins over it and kind of little like orange polka dots and stuff. So I'm going to do a time lapse of me doing that. So I'll show you guys. So this is what it looks like so far. I'm going to wait for it to dry and do one more coat, and then I will paint the rest of it. I just don't want to get black paint all over my hands. But basically I am going to be doing one with pumpkins. I'm gonna be painting another one and putting some skeletons on it. Another one, I'm just gonna do like some leaves and stuff, and I haven't figured out what I'm gonna do with the fourth one, but I'm actually gonna look up some inspiration as well. But basically be creative. If you wanted to do it like all kinds of cool colors, you could do half of it, you know, you could do like black on the top and Frankenstein on the bottom, which is actually what I might do with another one. But just make it kind of cute, make it fall festive. You could draw cats on it if you want it. Basically anything that reminds you of Halloween, do it. If you just wanted to paint it all black and then put like a Halloween picture on the inside, you guys could do that as well. But yeah, that is what I'm gonna do. So I will get back to you guys in a moment. So just an update on the frames that I did. I painted one like Frankenstein. So basically all I did was do green paint about halfway up and make black for his hair. And then for this one, I did two little ghosts and I said, you are beautiful, beautiful. Because you know, ghosts So the other two, I think I'm going to paint one orange, like a pumpkin, and then I'm going to do another one, probably with just some pumpkins on the other side, or maybe I'll do someone similar to that. So obviously, like I said before, do whatever you feel is creative. So I will do a time lapse of me doing the other two, and then we will move on into the mugs, and then you guys will have three different ways you guys can give gifts to people or DIY your house for Halloween. So these are what the final product turned out. One is a candy corn, one is Frankenstein, one I attempted to make look like a pumpkin, and one says you are beautiful. Here, my dad, you love that. So I'm gonna be moving on to the mugs. So basically the mugs are gonna be custom for my friends. So these are ones that I'm making for four of my friends. Well, three friends, one somebody else, but that's a different story. So basically this is just ideas I'm doing for them, but they're going to be kind of generic, like what you could do for anybody, but some of them are going to be a little bit more custom. So I'm going to be using Sharpie and paint. So yeah, let's do the first one. I'm going to be doing, it's going to say resting witch face, and I'm going to do that in black, and I'm going to paint the inside orange. You guys know who it's for, then you guys know who it's for, but I'm going to do that for my first one. So far this is what it looks like. So this is resting witch face, and I have orange on the inside. I'm debating painting it, but I don't think I'm going to. I think I'm just gonna leave it with the Sharpie, but I might paint it. But yeah, this is mug number one. So the next one that I'm going to be doing is a little ghost, so I'm going to do that right now. So in this one I put you are beautiful, and I drew a ghost on this side. So this one I believe I will be giving to Maddie. Finally, I'm going to be making the and Gabby matching ones that say best witches forever. So I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna do like a cute little design on the inside or something. So here we go. Mugs ended up looking like, and then this one on the back has you are beautiful. So I hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. Make sure you guys hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and comment on future video ideas. Hit the bell next to the subscribe button so you guys get notified when I upload a video. Let me know if you guys try the you okay down there.
Yeah.
Cool. But yeah, I will see you guys tomorrow. You guys, for another video, you guys are going to see what I'm using these for, because I'm going to film that video right now. So you guys are going to be seeing next week, but I love you guys so much, and I hope that you guys have a great Sunday, and I'll see you guys tomorrow for another baking video. Bye guys. Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight.